Welcome to Ever After, a Once Upon a Time podcast, Season 7, Episode 1, Hyperion Heights. In this episode, Henry encounters a troubled Cinderella in a distant realm and is forced to make difficult choices. Meanwhile, Henry's daughter, Lucy, finds him disillusioned at his home in Seattle and must make him remember his true self to defeat the curse. I am your host, Molly Southgate, and with me is...
Martha Southgate.
And Rob Southgate.
Good to be back.
Oh, I loved this episode.
This is fun. I like this.
I love Ronnie.
Now, we know already that they've canceled, that they're, this is the final season.
Yeah, that's why we're going back. We had said we weren't going to do this new edition of it, or maybe just kind of do occasionals, but they did announce that it's over.
Mm-hmm.
They're going to finish out this season.
So are we.
Yeah.
So we're going to do every episode, just like we've done in the past, mm-hmm. and I'm surprised how fun it is.
You know, I really am enjoying this new... I would not have enjoyed it if it was doing the same thing it did every other season.
Yeah.
But because this is a reboot.
Yes.
And it's new and it's fresh. And
I really am having Cinderella. Fun with this.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, you know, it's funny because when this episode started and they started having, you know, they have Lucy show up at his mm-hmm. place, at Henry's place. I started to go, you know, I like that very beginning when Henry's going to go off and there's that prospect of all these other versions of the stories. And I was like, oh, this is really cool. This like ignites my imagination here. And then they had Lucy come to his place. I'm like, it's the same story.
Yeah.
And I thought, okay, how interested am I going to be?
Mm-hmm.
And then he found Cinderella and I still kind of felt that way.
Yeah. Well, and Victoria is no Regina.
No.
So for her to be the big baddie, it's not really...
I like her.
It's not really getting me, but I...
I love Regina.
I love Regina.
Well, yeah. And
I love Ronnie. I love Ronnie.
It did get me, though, at some point. Like, even though they did a really good job of saying... here's what it is. I think I figured it out while I was watching it. It's not that it's like, oh, they're going back to the well and doing the same story.
Mm-hmm.
It was when Henry had said, I'm not in any of these other stories.
Right.
They are forced to play out these stories kind of over and over in different ways. This is his story.
Yeah.
But it's a different take on it. That all of a sudden I'm like,
no, I love that.
I'm into it.
I'm just saying, because he said, I'm not in any of them. He is now.
He is.
But I'm just saying, if we're going to compare it to the initial one where Henry goes to Emma and finds Emma and does that, Regina is a way better baddie.
Oh, yeah, like, Regina was an awesome bad guy.
And can you imagine if Regina had been told no, that you can't have this bar?
Yeah.
Like, I just feel like...
She would have just burned it to the ground.
I'm not really interested in this Victoria as I was in Regina.
And she's trying... And it kind of seems like she's trying to, like, make up for what she's done. And sometimes she's like, I do care about them. And it's like...
Wait, who? Regina?
Victoria.
She says certain... I'm like, oh, well, that's...
No, I don't think she is. In fact, they said, I think she's doing what Regina did, where Regina played like she was a normal person, but she knew she was evil.
Yeah.
I think that, what's her name?
Victoria.
Victoria Belfry.
Yes. Is the one that knows about the curse. She has the memory.
Well, then that I hope that's not true, because that's a little bit too similar.
Like,
I'd rather it just be a different storyline. I like Cinderella.
I like her
Lucy.
Step-sister.
I like this new Henry.
Yeah.
I like Hook.
Of course. And Hook is great. Having him back as Captain Officer Rogers.
What do you guys think of Alice?
Ooh, I like her.
I like this Alice.
I love when he's like, oh, you're Alice of Wonderland. And she's like, and other places. Why? One time trip.
Yeah.
Everyone thinks that I'm that. Just that.
Yeah. I like her and I like the take on it, and I like that she was self-aware. So when he started saying stuff at, you know, like about the story and that, she's like, you are in a different realm. Mm-hmm. Like it raised the stakes. And I love that Rumpelstiltskin has been in all these realms. She's like, he knows everybody.
Mm-hmm.
So do you think he knows, or is he just like, I don't know. Why are they there? Why are Rump and Regina there? Why is Hook there? Mm-hmm. Did Storybird
and
fall
apart?
And
why is it Hyperion Heights? Like, why did they, why did the curse stick them there?
Right.
In Seattle? And yeah. Why?
I don't know.
And what is this island going to have to do with things? Like,
yeah, and did Storybook, because at the end of the sixth season, I mean, everything was resolved. They're going to live their lives there and everything. What happened? How are they there? Did Henry leaving and going and doing his thing, did that do something else? Did that send a different trajectory? Or is this them in the other realms here? Like, are they going to start realizing I'm Regina, or is it like, no, she's a different Regina, just like it's a different Cinderella?
No, because they look exactly the same. Cinderella looks so different.
True.
And why aren't there two Cinderellas? Because there was a Cinderella in Storybrooke.
But so far, we've only seen a couple of the crossover characters. So we haven't seen the other ones. Like, if we saw every, if we started seeing everybody, then we could say, okay. And that, you know what, Molly, you do bring up a good point, though, because that was what kind of, like, lit me up at the beginning when he said there's all these different Cinderellas or there's all these different Snow Whites.
Yeah.
I thought, I started thinking, wouldn't it be wild if they all started having to interact? So there's
like, if they were friends or something.
The
like
French Snow White hates the Italian Snow White, hates the Native American Snow White, or they team up, or, like, you start seeing them, and like, he starts piecing together, oh, you're Snow White.
Yeah.
The story's different. Mm-hmm. The character's different, but Henry is the one that can see.
That knows. That,
yeah, yeah. And knows what they're capable of.
And you know? I also like the fact, one of the things that I really like is actually how they're kind of going back and having her come up and be like, I'm your daughter. Mm-hmm. And I think that's triggering it for Henry, going, ooh, I did that in the book, the character did that, but I think it's triggering him to go, ooh, I feel like I did that in real life.
Do you think so, Mark?
I don't think yet.
No. I don't think
not
so
not yet,
at all.
But it will.
Right, but you said it was.
It will, but I don't think so at all.
Busted.
It would.
Busted. yeah, I don't think it did, but I do think, well, it was obvious when Henry saw, or no, when Hook saw the picture of Emma, it was triggering something. But I think when he looked at the book, when Drusilla handed Hook, Officer Rogers, the book, he immediately, something started to connect. Something started to fire in his head.
Oh my gosh,
does he remember? No.
I think he's looking for Emma. Because there's that picture of her, and he was looking at it.
Maybe.
Yeah, I think he's searching. Triggered.
Maybe that's what happened. Maybe Emma has left Storybrooke.
Maybe
and that's
remembers.
Why they all went out looking for her. But then when this curse happened, it
they forgot.
They got stuck there.
Maybe mm-hmm. her Hook knows.
How are they going to go across? Because
he was kind of making a face with Rumple. He's like, "Oh, Rumple." It's like, "Oh, it's nice that you're my detective," but he was being.
Molly, I think you're reading stuff into it. I don't think he has any clue.
I wish he was, because that would be kind of cool.
I think that, and I don't even know if Rumple does, although he did look at him like he might know him, but I don't know. No. I don't know. I think we're reading into
maybe
that.
Maybe they just remember it, kind of like, I feel like I've met you.
Yeah, there's that little, you know, hairs on the back of your neck stand up, like there's something, but yeah, I don't think so. Just like the curse in the first one, none of them had a clue. They were kind of drawn to each other in certain ways, but they didn't have a clue. Maybe Rump has no clue, and that's why he's reverted back to being bad. Maybe, you know, maybe that's all it is. They just really, truly don't know. And they're not in the right story, because didn't Alice say, when you're not in the right story, bad things happen?
Yeah.
They're not in the right story. But I wonder if they went out looking for Emma.
I think maybe they went out looking for Emma and Henry. Maybe Emma left to look for Henry, and they were like, no, Emma, we need you.
Oh, that could be.
They went off to look for Emma, and then the curse fell over this town.
Yeah.
And then they got trapped in it.
Man, that I will say that I lost her name again.
Jacinda?
No.
Victoria?
Victoria. I want to call her.
Just call her Belfry.
Belfry. Maybe I can remember Belfry.
No, Victoria's good. We'll
but
no, but he said he made
the stepmother.
The stepmother. I'm going to go with the stepmother because I'm going to get it wrong every time. The stepmother killed the fairy the fairy godmother with no hesitation. Mm-hmm. So that was, when you're saying she's not as evil, that was pretty rough that she just goes, bibbidi bobbidi doo, boom, she's gone.
She technically didn't know it, that was going to happen.
Do you think?
She did. She went, is this how you do it? Bibbidi bobbidi boo. And then she did that, and then she went to dust.
And she's like, well, if Cinderella comes back, have her clean that up.
Yeah.
Yeah, I don't think she, I think she totally knew that she was going to do that. And like she was toying like a cat with a mouse,
the
fairy godmother.
I'm actually liking the stepsister character.
And she said, what happened to my wings? She goes, I cut them off when you were asleep.
Yeah, I clipped them. Yeah, whatever.
I cut them off.
She cut them off.
That's pretty rough.
And then the fairy was like, oh no. And she's like, don't seem so high and mighty without your wings, do you? And then she killed her.
Yeah, she's harsh.
The stepdaughter, but she's not Regina. I think she's going to be like in the extended universe for Cinderella. She's going to end up being more on Cinderella's side as she realizes how horrible she's been. I really do.
She doesn't seem like a bad person, but I'm liking her.
I feel like that storyline is Devil Meets Prada.
I was so going to say that. When she went in and everything, that was all right out of the
Devil Wears Prada. And the stepsister, when she came up with Hook.
Well, did you notice they made her look like her, too?
Yeah, I was like, she looks like the one of them from Devil Meets
Prada.
Well, what's that?
It's a movie.
Oh. Yeah. You know the Princess Diaries?
Yeah.
The girl who plays the princess in that, she plays the secretary to Meryl Streep's evil woman, who runs a company, and they call her the Devil Wears Prada.
Prada's a designer, clothing designer.
Okay.
So many things we have to explain when we explain that. Mm-hmm. And the one who played her, I can't think of her name, but she played Catwoman in
Anne Hathaway.
Yes.
I love her.
Yeah, she played Catwoman.
She's in every Disney movie, pretty much every live action one.
Is she?
Almost. She's in a lot.
All right. I'm going to hold you to that. I'm going to start watching.
She's in a lot.
All right. Are there any other points that we need to make before we go watch the next episode?
Well, let's see. There was...
So we
know the crux of the story is that Lucy is Henry's daughter. Henry is forgotten. She's going to try to put them back together and lift the curse. Mm-hmm.
And the grandma wants... The step-grandma wants Lucy.
Right. It's just like a ritual. That's why I'm hoping it doesn't go too much like that original story. But there were moments in this that took me far enough away that I was really digging.
Yeah, I agree.
Okay, here's what I want to know. I'm going back to episode one of Ever After.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
So like 200 episodes
Once upon
ago.
A time.
We're Ever After.
No.
Oh, Ever After. Okay.
No.
Maybe you guys have heard of it. It's a show we do called Ever After.
Wow, I never heard of that.
Okay, way back in episode one, we didn't know anything.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah, we made the worst
We started wondering
assumptions.
Who the characters were.
Right.
There were characters here.
Yeah.
Now, we caught one. You caught one at the ball.
Tiana.
Tiana.
And she's her roommate.
And she was cooking in her apartment.
And it looked like gumbo.
Yeah, and she was like, I'm not going to eat those frog legs.
You got up and you saw her and she was wearing the whole Tiana outfit. And then they're like, here, would you like this? She's like, ooh, frog legs. No, no.
Yeah,
and
I
like,
want to see more Tiana.
Yeah.
I love Tiana so much.
I think they right after Tiana, when they were panning across, I think it was supposed to be Belle and Beast.
Mm. Oh.
Because she was in the yellow and he had a blue coat on. And he put his hand out and she grabbed it and they started dancing. And I was like... That's this world's Beauty and the Beast.
Oh, okay.
I remember I remember once at the ball how they had everyone.
They were all there, yeah.
And it was like Snow White and the Prince were dancing. Tiana was there, I think.
The original world. The
original
world's
Tiana. It had a bunch of different. And you were like, oh, there's Beauty and Beast. There's them.
So who else do you think? Who do you think? The one cop. That worked with Hook. Any ideas?
I kept
on who
thinking,
he is?
Yeah, he's going to have to be somebody.
I was thinking he might be grumpy.
Yeah, I was thinking a dwarf, even though he's tall.
Right.
But I was thinking he had sort of an attitude
like one of the dwarves.
Yeah.
Or he could be the character that Graham played in the first.
The Huntsman?
Once upon a time.
Ooh, the Huntsman.
The Huntsman?
Yeah.
I'm just saying, like, if I'm thinking of cops,
the huntsman was all, like, valor and everything. This guy was like, oh, do you want me to look for your car under my desk?
Yeah, he reminded me of, my first thought was he was one of the dwarves.
And they don't have to be characters that we know either, but I kind of thought dwarf on that. Now, what was it, who was, she said it, Cinderella said at the beginning when her horse went away, and she was like, he was like, well, your horse, and she goes, Philippe.
Philippe, that's Belle's horse. Philippe is Belle's horse in Beauty and the Beast.
Is Philippe going to be a cursed person or something? Or is that...
Maybe.
That like cool. Are we going to find out that the officer is Philippe? Is like Philippe going to be a person? Oh, that would be cool.
Cause,
well, Prince Philip...
Is from which one? Isn't he from Sleeping Beauty?
Yeah, Prince Philip's from... But Philippe. Mm-hmm. Philippe specifically
was dad's horse.
Yes, in Beauty and the Beast.
And that's why Henry was like, in that world, was like, what? Philippe's your horse? And
yeah.
He's like, but you're Cinderella.
Yeah.
He was making...
The story's jumbled up.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. I just wondered if that's going to turn out to be... Because, you know, she turned... the mice into the things. If Philippe is going to be something that she turned into the horse.
Yeah. Could be.
Yeah. I loved her carriage and her dress.
So we really didn't figure out who anybody is.
Oh, nice job.
But we met Alice.
Yes.
I have a feeling that cop is somebody.
Yeah.
You know what? The other one I really want to figure out who he is the guy who owns the chicken place and the assistant. They are definitely people. The one who dropped the chicken is definitely somebody.
Maybe Goofy?
Goofy.
What?
Well, if they did bring Mickey Mouse into the last one.
They did?
Don't you remember the one guy was the Sorcerer's Apprentice?
Oh.
But I doubt it's Goofy. It's got to be a character.
No. You just said Goofy guy, and I was like, Goofy?
A character who's clumsy, you know? And the,
isn't there a dwarf that's clumsy?
Clumsy the dwarf?
No, it's like a dwarf, and he's clumsy, and it's not, and his name's not clumsy.
Let's see, there was happy,
bashful,
sweaty,
sneezy, sleepy, clumsy.
Sleepy.
Yeah, no, I don't think it's one of the dwarves.
Maybe it's sleepy.
Like, can we just watch another episode?
Okay. Yes, okay, well then that's it. Molly, you want to, you got any final thoughts on this?
I just thought it was great, and I can't wait to go on.
Yeah, I can't wait for the whole season. How about you, Marth? Anything?
Yeah, I'm all good.
That's it. All right. Follow us on social media. We will post it all in the show notes. Please rate us and review us wherever you get this podcast from, and you can subscribe. Subscribing means when you hit that button on iTunes or on Google, doesn't cost you anything. What it means is when a new episode posts, it's going to show up in your feed, and you're going to be alerted. You're going to know it's there. That way you won't miss one. And that should do it. We will give all our social media, like I said, in the show notes. Find us on Facebook. Find us on Twitter.
And support our Patreon.
Yeah, we have one for the company. Go to Patreon and look up Southgate Media Group. And it supports the whole network, even a buck a month. If you're not sure how Patreon works, basically you sign up to donate once a month, like on the first of the month. You can make it $1, you can make it $5, you can make it $10, and every month it'll just take it out of your account, and it goes directly to us to help support the network. And we have some perks and things that we offer in there. Just go to Patreon and you'll figure that all out. And if you want to write to us, you can write to us at southgatemediagroup@gmail.com. Now let's end this the way every great fairy tale ends.
Happily ever after.
The end.